This video is my candid and frank talk about my current financial situation. So, I went to I graduated from New York University with a bachelor's in social work. The way I was able to obtain this bachelor's degree was through college loans. The first year of my college I was able to afford that because through the help of my parents. My parents at the time moved to a different house, and while they were while they bought a new house and moved there, they sold their old house. So the money they got from their old house, the good portion of that, about $30,000, they were able to use that money to be able to pay for my first year of college. And I really said they didn't need to do that, but they helped me. So that first year was paid off like that. The next three years of college, of course, most of it, I paid it through loans. I guess I wasn't that smart enough to think ahead, but I got loans through CitiBank, and all are private loans. So the second year that I got, the loan is about $30,000. The third year is $30,000, and the last year is about $36,000. And with interest accrued, my total amount that I owe to CitiBank is about $105,000. So that's, you know, it's a huge amount of money to owe some organization, to owe a bank that amount of money, you know, amount of money that I could buy a house with, you know, if I go to where my parents are and they're in Tennessee, you know, I could find a house to live in with $100,000. So I pretty much bought a house with, but instead of buying a house, I bought an education. And it's, at the time, like, I majored in social work. So I was thinking, yeah, I won't be paid this much. Social work is not a very high-paying profession, especially the field that I want to go into, which is kind of related to community organizing, fighting poverty, helping homeless people, or, you know, helping the formerly incarcerated. So the people who were in prison but recently got out, helping them readjust to society. That's pretty much, that's the stuff that I want to do. That's the stuff I have passion for. Of course, it's not the stuff that pays that much, right? But my idea is that social work is such an integral part, such an important work. Social work is always needed in society. So I thought jobs will be needed. All, you know, getting a job as a social work major would be incredibly, I guess, easier than, because it's always needed. This job is high in demand. That was my mentality when I went to get this degree. I graduated, and something happened. You know, so I actually planned to kind of, you know, I didn't do so hot on establishing connections that I need to for, like, reference letters. So I didn't feel insecure about kind of applying for grad school to get a good master's degree. So I actually plan to get into the job market, get into the nonprofit field, and get some experience, like 1 or 2 or 3 years. Not 1 year. 1 year would be too short. 2 or 3 years. Working in a nonprofit field, maybe as an administrative assistant, case management technician, anything that I can do as a bachelor's degree, get my hands dirty with the nonprofit work, improve myself, improve my skills, get those connections that will provide me with reference letters, then go to grad school, get my master's in social work, and become a social worker. That was my career plan. Didn't turn out that way. Didn't turn out that way because my parents had to move from California to Tennessee. My dad got a so my dad is a pastor and my mom's a nurse. So that's so my dad was pretty much, my mom was a breadwinner in my house. She was the one who earned the money, and my dad was pretty much the one who took care of the house and raised me. So in my family, that's how the gender role dynamic worked, right? My dad was the caretaker, and my mom was the breadwinner. Anyway, what happened was my dad as a pastor had some trouble with his church. And he went to his denomination head, Assembly of Godhead, and division, and taught and said, "Is there a church in the United States that would require assistance, so I could become the pastor of that church?" And just that time is when an opportunity arrived in Tennessee. There was struggling church. He was assigned to there. He went there. He went in January. And I was supposed to graduate in May. So this happened like right before I was to graduate. And then afterwards, in March, my mom quit her job. either quit or fired. I'm not really too sure on the story. But anyway, that happened. So she got her unemployment. So I think she was fired. I'm not too sure on the details anyway. So she had to go to Tennessee. So after I graduated, I went to California to be with my mom. But then we had to all move to Tennessee. So our entire family moved to Tennessee. My mom is out of work. And my dad is still trying to get himself established in this really struggling church, which has become not only bankrupt, but is in, the previous pastor kind of made the church bankrupt and ran away. That's what happened. So that's the kind of situation he's in. And my dad, in order to help the church, has agreed to accept a salary that is much lower than what he's supposed to be getting. In fact, I think the first 2 months he didn't get any pay at all. I'm not really sure what happened, but that was the case. The church is in a horrible financial situation. It's in a horrible, actually, a lot of the church members left because of the political issues that happened. So I actually had to kind of put my life on hold to help my parents for 4 months. And I'm giving it, so after I graduate college, Citibank gives me about 6 months grace period, right? That's the time I should spend to find a job to be able to afford the rent, the loan payments that I need to make. 6 months, pretty much. But I ended up spending about 4 months helping my parents out. So already that set me back a lot. When I came back to New York in my apartment, the problem was it was a really bad time for job searching. It's like the holiday season, so not a lot of places are hiring, and the only opportunity I got was as a canvasser for a Green Roots campaign, and I didn't make the staff. So they have this fundraising or canvassing is very tough in a way, because you have to meet a quota. You have to meet a fundraising quota, and I didn't meet the quota to make the team. Although I did raise a good amount of money, I wasn't able to meet the requirement to make the staff. So I didn't make the staff, but I did earn about $300 through that experience. So that's the state I'm in. I go back to Tennessee for a month just to request their help, right? So I go there, I help my parents out, and I'm able to get a lot of money through the church members there. It's very, very generous and kind. So I came back with job search in mind, and that's when I came back is when my grace period was kind of over. So I'm hit with the loan payment. I have to make $868 a month to Citibank. And of course, I can't make it. I don't have a job. My mom doesn't have a job. My dad makes barely $2,000 on his salary as a pastor. So that's the situation I've been in, and it's been hard finding a job until I eventually found a job, and I'm currently employed as a tutor in a nonprofit company called Champion Learning Center. So I'm currently working as a tutor, but this company is closing for the summer, actually. So it closes in the summer and it starts up again in September. So I'm in the process of being unemployed, about to be unemployed again, and I have to be job searching again. In the meanwhile, my loan situation is as follows. So I have to make $868 a month to Citibank, but currently my delinquent amount, which is the money I haven't been able to pay back, and it's been accruing, is $1,600. The balance is at about $1,600. And it's about 60 days late. So for 60 days, I haven't been able to pay this amount that I'm supposed to be paying them. And so I'm getting late fees, and my credit score is probably getting, totally killed. And my co-signers are my parents, and they're not in the financial situation to be able to help me either. So this is the financial rut I'm in. I just wanted to share that with you. It's a pretty desperate situation, especially in the coming months, because by June, it's pretty much guaranteed that I will have to move to a new place, because one of my roommates is not going to live with us, and the other roommate, she's not sure whether she'll live with me or by herself. So I know for sure that by June, I have to move, and moving process is going to cost a lot of money, probably. Either cost a lot of money or it's just very unstable. So that's my situation. And I get collection calls from Citibank like very, very frequently. Sometimes like 3 times a day, sometimes 4 times a day. They're very nice people. You know, when I do answer the phone, I talk to them, I explain my situation. They're very understanding. They're very kind and considerate. And you know, it's just really great talking with them, but it's at the time, it's so guilt-ridden because having to owe someone this much money and not being able to pay them back makes me feel like a thief. But there's nothing I can do right now. You know, right now, I'm to pay my living expenses is such a higher priority than paying, you know, loan payments. And I would love to, but it's kind of hard. So that's my situation that I wanted to share.